Welcome, mindful parents. In this video, I'll be answering the question of how to deal with a tantrum when it happens in public or in front of your family. Sometimes the first thing you want to do is just stop your child from crying. And what happens most of the time is that the crying just becomes even worse, and your child will start screaming and yelling and kicking and hitting. The best thing to do in public is take your child to a corner, or if you can, go to a different room. Hold your child, sit down on the floor. If your child is being violent, they're hurting themselves, or they are kicking and screaming and they're trying to hit you, you simply and gently hold them from the back and sit down on the floor and tell them that you will let go when they calm down. If they are just crying, then just leave them. You don't have to hold them. Look at them and tell them that you will be there for them, that when they're done, you're right there to listen to them. And if they needed a hug, you are there waiting for them to come to you so you can give them a hug. It is very important that we let our child cry it out. When we stop them before they get all that frustration and anger out, what happens is that not a long time after that tantrum, another tantrum will happen. So it's very important that you let your child let it all out. It's like you, when you feel like you've had it and you start crying, you don't want somebody to come to you and say, stop crying. You will feel so much better after you are all done crying. When you let all that anger and frustration and sadness out, you feel better. So make sure that you allow your child to let it all out and not stop them. And I know sometimes it's not possible. And I know sometimes when you are in the middle of the airport trying to get to the airplane, that is not an option. But the option that you will do is carry your child and take them with you. You will not have time to sit down there and take it slow. And when you reach the airplane, for example, you can tell them, I know that you were frustrated and I know that you were angry, but I could not leave you there. We needed to leave right there and then. This is just an example. You can put that example into whatever situation you are in. If you are able to slow down and go to a corner and let that anger all out, great. If you were not able to, of course, grab them with kindness and take them with you, and then later on when you reach your destination, tell them that I knew that you really needed to cry and I knew that you were really upset and angry, but I could not leave you there. It is important that when you take them to a different room, that you are in a space that is safe for them. As I said, sit down on the floor with them and make sure everything around them is safe. If they are trying to throw something that is not safe, replace it with something that they can throw. For example, you can say, well, you cannot throw that vase, but you can throw this pillow if you feel like this helps. So try and replace whatever is going to hurt them with something that would actually make them feel better. So if it's okay for them, or if they feel like punching a pillow, go ahead and punch that pillow. It doesn't really hurt anybody, but it will get that frustration out of their body into the pillow. And if you are not able to find a corner or go to a different room, depending on where you are in public, I would just take that child to the car. Grab your child, hold them in a way that their legs are kicking to the back and you're holding them from their arms. If this is how you are going to do it, who cares what people are going to say, as long as you are holding him in a safe way, they're not hurting you or they're not hurting themselves. Take them to the car and let that calmness be in that car. So make your car as the place where you will wait for them until they calm down. Do not drive home when they are frustrated and angry, because you're the one who's going to be so frustrated and angry and you would just not concentrate on your driving. The key for this is consistency. And I know this sounds inconvenient at times, but this is very important. You have to stop everything you are doing and focus on that tantrum and do the same exact thing every single time. You might start off with half an hour or an hour of tantrum, but trust me, after a while, when the child knows they can trust you and they can let all that anger out in a safe way, that tantrum will decrease and will become a lot less. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions or comments, make sure to leave them below. Remember to create peace at home for a peaceful world.